sector as well. But apart from that, the stimulus that could be coming for the Indian economy to arrest the kind of slowdown that we have been witnessing. Clearly, from September 2018, the kind of liquidity that has dried up into the system, it's clearly impacted the consumption space, it's impacted the auto sector as well. And that's something which is really concerning, on the growth levels as well. Let me welcome in Aditi Nair, Principal Economist at ICRA. Aditi, good morning and welcome to the show. My first question coming to you is, there are reports suggesting right now that the government is looking to reverse the economic slowdown that we have been witnessing, and this would be actually with a stimulus package. How big a possibility is this going to be?
Good morning. Well, certainly we do seem to be in the midst of a slowdown in various sectors. We got more and more evidence coming in. The IIP data last week was additional confirmation of the same. 15 of the 23 manufacturing industries contracted, and we had a contraction in primary in three of the six major use-based categories as well. So there is an issue as far as the volume growth is concerned, and more industries, that's becoming quite apparent. Liquidity is definitely an issue, and what we've been seeing for the last several weeks is that lower interest rates alone are not going to be adequate to be able to reverse the slowdown, because there are constraints that a lot of sectors are facing that are simply not related to interest rates alone. Liquidity is definitely an issue. Now we do expect that the RBI, having already brought in 110 basis points of rate cuts, is going to use signals and words possibly to push transmission first, and liquidity as far as the system is concerned, banking system is concerned, is in large surplus. So that as well as the systemic level is not an issue. What is an issue is a flow of liquidity to specific sectors and perhaps to specific corporates or corporate groups who are not able to access that liquidity because of specific issues. So possibly what we need to look at now is not just further action from the RBI, but have the government come in as well and look at policies and reforms that can be undertaken quickly that will help the overall economy, and perhaps also some sector-specific initiatives, although we always run the risk of putting out a package to support one sector and then having a lot of other sectors request for similar packages. So within the fiscal space which is available, I think the government will have to do a little bit of a balancing act.
Absolutely. Aditi, you know, there have been multiple voices from the industry, from policymakers, asking for a GST cut in autos. I mean, how feasible is that? Because auto is a big contributor to government revenue, which in any case is under pressure. If it goes from 28 to 18%, then what's to stop from some of the other sectors like cement also pushing forward with this demand? So there is a dilemma for government whether to go ahead with this auto GST cut or not. How feasible do you think it will be for the government to do that?
You're absolutely right. That's what I just said, that you can put out a package for one sector, but then there are going to be so many other sectors clamoring for similar support for them as well. And cement, you know, like what you were just playing the bite before on housing, cement is an integral part of housing and construction and various infrastructure projects as well. So we could definitely expect to see a similar demand coming in from the cement manufacturers association if there is a GST cut which is made for auto. So I think this is something that the government will have to think through very carefully in terms of the fiscal space which is available. If I remember correctly, if you look at the headline numbers for GST for the last month and look at the YOY growth, it was barely 5 to 6%. So even though it was over 1 lakh crore, the YOY growth was, you know, just about 5 to 6%, which is lower than anybody's real GDP growth projection for FY20 that I've seen so far. It's certainly lower than mine. Also, there is a concern in terms of the overall tax growth. Even the June tax numbers that we got for April to June did point to a lot of slack as far as the internet tax collections was concerned. And I think that the government will have to be very careful in looking at the fisc and seeing whether space is available, because we have to remember that GST rate cuts don't just affect the center, but they affect states as well. So will the states agree So such rate cuts as well is something that we'll have to wait and see.
Right. So Aditi, you know, taking all of this into consideration, what is the kind of relief package we should be watching out for? Because even over the weekend, you had Prime Minister Narendra Modi, who came out and clearly indicated that the entrepreneurs are going to be the growth ambassadors from here on. And the vision for the next 5 years is to have investment-led growth. And he's targeting almost 100 lakh crore worth of investments in the coming 5 years and working on policies to promote inflows. Now, taking all of this into consideration, is it that Prime Minister Narendra Modi is actually betting on the millennials of the world from here on?
Well, I think in terms of a package, first of all, we should be looking at policies and reforms that can be brought in quickly to be able to unleash a cross-sectoral kind of a push and stimulus as far as the economy is concerned. Secondly, I would actually start with looking at the infrastructure sector. There are a lot of government projects which would be at an award stage or, you know, ready for award with perhaps some more clearances that would be required. So maybe that is something that can be pushed, because I, as an economist, I firmly believe that infrastructure, no matter what part of the country it's in, it's very democratic to really push infrastructure growth, and we have a large deficit in infrastructure in many, many parts of the country. So this is something that really could be expedited and pushed very quickly, because it's also something which lifts the constraints to growth in many, many sectors. You know, particularly looking at logistics, reducing the time taken to get to ports for exporters or anywhere across the country in terms of moving goods, it's something that would always be appreciated. Whether it's investment in power, drinking water, you know, these are things which affect not only households but also industries. So there's a lot that can be done, and if financing is not an issue, I mean, this is certainly something that can create jobs, support other jobs, and also result in maybe double-digit growth for many years to come. But the caveat, of course, is if financing is not an issue. So I think that's partly, you know, part of the puzzle that would have to be worked out.
Point taken, Aditi. Thank you so much for putting that in perspective for us. Let's see what those stimulus measures can be. There have been multiple reports over the last entire week. Government's going to do something for FPIs. After that meeting on Friday especially, there was some excitement on the street. Nothing really came of it. In fact, most FPIs came out disappointed with that meeting. Now, of course, you're hearing that the Prime Minister's office is vetting some of the stimulus measures that are being planned for the economy. They could be announced this week. But again, a lot of that is conjecture at the moment. We'll wait and see for any concrete announcements coming on that part, but the flows are